Hello guys, I am Paul McWhorter from toptechboy.com, and today we're going to be looking at Arduino lesson number 4, and what we're going to be looking at is how to print from the Arduino over the serial port. And if you've been with us from the first 3 lessons, you can see that we've done some pretty interesting things with the Arduino so far, but we're pretty much kind of having the Arduino talk to the circuit and sort of working down here in this little box where the Arduino makes the circuit do things that we tell it to do. But as you start developing more sophisticated programs, you start needing to get the ability to send data and send information from the Arduino back to your computer screen. You need to be able to print things on this computer screen. So what we're going to be doing today is we are going to be looking at how you can print things from the Arduino microcontroller to your over your serial port to your computer screen. The circuit that we're going to be using is the same circuit that we used in Arduino lesson number 3, and so if you still have that set up, you should be in good shape. If you don't have it set up, you can pause the video here and put it together according to this schematic. I'm not going to go through now. I've sort of gone through slowly with you the first 3 lessons and actually built it with you. But at this point, you should be confident enough in the in how the breadboard works that you can do this yourself. If you're not completely comfortable, go back and review the first 2 or 3 videos, and you can see how the breadboard works and how to get these things hooked up. But at this point, I need to start moving along a little bit quicker, and so we will just show you this and let you hook it up on your own. Similarly, at the end of lesson number 3, you should have ended up with some like this. And this is the code that we're running right now down in the microcontroller. And what it does is it makes the red LED blink 5 times, and then it makes the yellow LED blink 5 times. And we basically, just to recap this program really quickly, in lesson number 3, we learned how to do 4 loops. And so basically the number of times that either the yellow blinks or the red blinks is controlled right here. You can see num yellow blinks is equal to 5 and num red blinks is equal to 5. We're declaring our variables here. We could have called the variables anything that we wanted to, blinky yellow number, whatever you wanted to call it, you could call it. But you want to name it something that when you come back later, you clearly know what it is. And so it's been a while since I've worked with this program, but I clearly can see that num yellow blinks is telling me that's the number of times the yellow LED blinks, and num red blinks is the number of times that the red LED blinks. And so naming your variables well makes it easy to come back later and work with your work with your program. Remember, in we had 2 LEDs, and so they're connected to 2 different output pins on the Arduino, 2 different digital pins. I believe we are using pins 9 and 10. You could use different ones, 0 to 13 are your digital pins that you can use. I chose 9 and 10 just because those are the ones I like. Okay, when you use pins, you have to tell Arduino, is that pin going to be an input or an output? So we set our pin modes to outputs because we're going to be outputting to those pins. Void setup is where you do things that you're going to do once, and then we came down to void loop. In the void loop, we loop through our first for loop, or the void loop is here. Then we have a for loop that controls the blinking of the red LED. And how many times do we go through this loop? We go through it num red blinks, which we set up here at the top of the program. Then we go through a second for loop, which controls the number of times that the yellow LED blinks. And so we blink this many times for red, this many times for yellow. And you should be very comfortable with this at this point. If you're not, go back and watch the earlier videos. So this is the program that we're using. Hopefully you typed this in last time, but if you didn't, you can go ahead and grab the code here. It's okay if you grab the code if you've sort of already done it yourself, but I just want to kind of give you a heads up that you don't want to just go through these lessons copying and pasting from the code that I do. You really want to get in there and type it in, because when you type it in, you make mistakes, and when you make mistakes, you have to go find them. And unless you get through that exercise now of being able to make mistakes, find mistakes, and correct them, you'll just never get anywhere in coding. It's one of the hard things about writing a computer program. It's one of the things that you have to get good at: debugging and troubleshooting. Debugging is kind of talking more about the software side of things. Troubleshooting is talking a little bit bit more about the hardware side of things. And so debugging and troubleshooting is something you've got to get good at. And therefore, I really ask you to not, as a matter of practice, just go in and copy my code, but you need to type it in yourself. You need to make mistakes, and then you need to figure out how to find those mistakes, because that's what sort of separates the men from the boys in coding. Is it's the people that can find their mistakes. Okay, so this is the program that we're running right now. And what you can see is that you can change the number of times those things blinks by these two lines of code that are right up here. If I set it to 10 and 5, that would change the number of times that things are blinking. And so this is all pretty slick, and this is all pretty neat stuff. But like I say, at some point, you want to start getting to where I'm not just making things happen down here, but I'm getting information from that circuit and getting it up, or from that project, the microcontroller and the circuit, and getting it into my main computer where I can see things on the screen here. And so that's what we're going to start looking at, is how can you print from the Arduino microcontroller to your screen. And in order to do that, what you basically do is you have to talk over the serial port, okay? And if you wonder what the serial port are those USB connections on your computer. Those are your serial ports. And you can see that already your Arduino is connected to your computer by a USB cable. So you already have a cable running over the serial port to make that connection. But what you have to do is, inside of the Arduino, you have to turn that serial port on for the use of the Arduino program. And you need to turn the serial port on one time. So you would put that command where? You would put that command in the void setup, because the setup is for things that you need to do once. And this is how you turn on the serial port. You say serial.begin9600. And if you're wondering where I am looking at all of this stuff, I am on my website, which is toptechboy.com. And we are looking at Arduino lesson number 4. And so again, don't copy and paste this, but do make note that when you write this serial, the S is capital, serial.begin9600. So to turn on the serial port, you need to come to your program and you need to go to the void setup. I'm going to do that before I even do my pin modes. And I'm going to say serial.begin9600. Okay? And we always end in a semicolon. So what you can see here is that we now have turned on the serial port. If I downloaded it, the serial port would be open and ready for communication. But that really is not very interesting, because it doesn't do anything. So then let's go and say, how would we actually send something? How would we actually send something over the serial port? And we do that with one of two commands. We either give a command of serial.print or serial.println. That's for print line, serial.print or serial.println. The difference between the two is, if we do a serial.println, after it does the print, after it prints your last character, it goes to the next line. After it does the last character, it goes to the next line. If you just do a serial.print after the last character, it stays on that line. So if I wanted to print three different things on the same line and then go to the next line, I would need to do serial.print, serial.print, and then on the last one, serial.print line to take me to the new line. So you really, to get nicely formatted text, you need to keep track of the difference between serial.print and serial.println. And so what we're going to do is, we're going to start just with serial.println to kind of make it a little bit easier to get started. So remember, here in this loop, this for loop is the loop that is blinking the red LED. So we blink the red LED, we go through this loop, numRed blinks time, that was set at the top of the program, and then basically we turn the LED high, we then wait, we turn the LED low, and then we wait. So it's like on, wait, off, wait, on, wait, off, wait. And we can sit there and loop through this, and we can control these parameters up at the top of the program, and that's what we talked about last week. But this week we are going to start looking at printing, and so I'm going to print like what number of, what position am I in this loop? How many times have I gone through it? Well, our counter J keeps track of how many times we've gone through, because each time through, J is incremented by 1, so let's just print J. We would say serial.print, and then we would say, and we're going to do print ln because we want it to go to the next line, and then we are going to print what? We are going to print J. And so let's look, and what did I do wrong here? Look at that. This is not turning orange like it should. Serial is always S, like I told you earlier. Serial.println. We want print ln, so it'll just every time go to the next line. And J is the variable. So look at our formatting here. Serial.println, open parentheses, close parentheses, and you can only put one variable in here. I couldn't say like print J and print this and print this. You have to have separate print statements for each thing that you're printing. But we're going to print the variable J, and so this should count up to numblinks, which is 5, so it should count up to 5, and then it should start over as it goes through and then comes back and loops again. So let's go ahead and run this program and see what happens. Everything's green, that's good, everybody's happy, no mistakes. Now, why is it not printing? Well, because you've got to look at the serial monitor, okay? And the serial monitor you get to by clicking on this little icon here. And look at this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And so as it's in this loop, it's printing. We did not put a print statement in the yellow loop, and so it is not printing there. It is only printing in the red loop because that's the only place that we put a print statement. Now let's look at one thing that's very important. When I said serial.begin 9600, the 9600 is what's called the baud rate. That's basically how fast it's going to be talking to and listening to the serial port. And there's a lot of different choices of what baud rates you can choose. 9600 works pretty well. Doesn't matter that much what baud rate you set it to, but what does matter is whatever you set this to, everything has got to be set to the same baud rate. So if this is 9600 down here on your serial monitor, that needs to be 9600. If this is running at 9600 and we come down here and run real fast at 11,000 or 115,200, you see we don't get anything because they can't talk to each other if they're talking at different speeds. For these two things to communicate, they have to be at the same baud rate. So let's put it back at 9600 and see if we can get it going again. Yep, there it's going, looking good. Everybody's happy. And this isn't just between talking, this isn't about just talking between the microcontroller and the serial monitor. Anytime that you're using a serial port, everybody has to be on the same speed. 9600 is kind of a typical one that you use. If you're really doing something that's going to be happening fast where you need to get a lot of data going through there, usually the serial port is kind of like the slowest part of your program. And if you want to speed it up, you could come down and make it faster. But if I make it faster here, 115,200, I have to come over here and I have to make it 115,200. Okay, and now if I come back to the serial monitor, it's not working. How come? Because when I change something here, I have to send it back to the Arduino. Changing something here does not change things down in the Arduino. When you change things up here, you have to download it, or you, I guess they call it upload here, depends on your perspective, but you have to upload it back into the Arduino. So we made the change. Let's send it back to the Arduino. Comes in, everybody is happy here. We should see things in just a second. And what happened there? Let's try it again. Sometimes it just takes more than once. Every once in a while it kind of hangs up. Okay, everybody's happy this time. Now let's look at the serial monitor. This is set at 115,200. This is set at 115,200. And now we're getting our numbers in. Okay, one thing that I don't like really too well about this is that you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but it's sort of hard to see where the loop ended and where the next one starts. So it would be good to kind of have a blank line between the 5 and the 1. And so what we can do is we can just print a blank line. And so here we're doing print line, print line, print line, print line. Well, after we leave the loop, and remember the loop closes when you close the clause here. The loop closes with that curly bracket. After that curly bracket, let's put another serial print line in. And we want to just print a blank. And the way we do a blank is we just print a blank string. We can just print an open quote, a space, and a close quote. And we can then close the parentheses. And what that's going to print is just one white space. And then that's going to put nice little formatting in there. And again, we use the print line. So let's come here and let's download it again. Things are looking good. And let's now look at our serial monitor. Now we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and a blank space. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then a blank space. And you see how much easier this is to read? You can sort of see I'm in the loop. I'm stopped. I'm going through the yellow loop, and now I'm back to the red loop. And it's just so much easier if you put a little effort into formatting your text, as we've seen here. It can be pretty easy. Well, let's look and see what happens if we did a serial print instead of a serial print line on this one. Okay, let's do a serial print. That means it's not going to go to the next line. It's going to just print across the line until we get to this one, and then it's going to go down. And you can see that if you're not thoughtful in the way that you use your serial print, and that must not have downloaded. Let's see. I'm sorry about the difference between upload and download. I think that I'm downloading into the Arduino. It thinks it's being uploaded too. So let's go here. Let's look at the serial monitor now. And now what you see is we're printing across the row because we did serial prints. Then we print, go to the next one when we do this print line. And we're printing across here. But you see, that starts looking like 12,345 instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you got to be really careful about not being thoughtful in using your print instead of print line. So we're going to go back to print line, make it look, and I keep forgetting to click the download button. All right, let's see here. Okay, so this should be back to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, now when we printed this blank character, what we were really printing a string or a string of characters, and that string of character had one character, and that was a blank. But we can actually print characters that would be a little more useful. So let's come up here, and before the for loop, let's put in another serial print. So let's say serial.print. And I usually use println, and then I'm going to print a string. To print a string, the string needs to be in what? It needs to be in quotes. And for Arduino, it needs to be the double quotes. Which LED is going to be blinking here? This is the red, so the red LED is blinking! Exclamation. Close your parentheses, end in a semicolon. So always on your serial print lines, you have your parentheses, and then inside your parentheses, whatever is in quotes, the red LED is blinking, will be printed out. Okay, it just takes whatever is in here and it prints it out. So now let's download that and see what happens. I'm sorry, I'm just going to say download. I don't care if this says thinks it's being uploaded. I'm going to call it download. All right, so let's go here. And look at this, the red LED is blinking, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's not printing in the yellow loop, but it's back to the red loop. The red LED is blinking, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, the red LED is blinking, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is pretty neat stuff, okay? So all of a sudden now, if we look down here, this is kind of linking up. The red LED is blinking, and if you look down here in the circuit, when the yellow LED is blinking, it's not printing, but it does tell you right in sync with the red LED here on the serial monitor. And this is useful. You're giving useful information to your user. Maybe if you're trying to debug your program, printing things out here on the serial monitor can help you find errors and can help you figure out what is going wrong with your program. Okay? Well, let's try something else now. Let's try an example where you would actually want to do a serial print. And this is also an example of how you would be possibly you would be possibly putting a string and a variable on the same line. And also, let's just take a second and look here. When I said serial print line J, the J was not in quotes because I did not want to print the character J. I wanted to print the variable J. The variable J is our counter. So if I want to print a variable, I just put it in as the variable. If I want to print a string, I put it in quotes. But if I'm printing a string, I've got to be sure and I've got to put the quotes, or it would be looking for a variable name. The red LED is blinking. So you have to think, I want to print what's in quotes if I'm printing a string. If I'm just printing a variable, I just put the variable in. And that is something that's important. But let's say that we want to print a string and a variable on the same line. What might we want to do there? Well, what we might want to do is we might want to come in here and we might want to do a serial.print and then put in the string you are on blink number, and then I would put in a colon. And then, I mean, yeah, that was a colon, and then I would, I forgot to end the quote. And how I saw that I'd forgotten that it didn't turn blue, and so that kind of clued me in that I'd forgotten my close quote. You always got, whatever you open, you got to close. If I open the parentheses, I got to close the parentheses. If I open the curly bracket, I got to close the curly bracket. If I open the quote, I got to close the quote. And a lot of times when you have problems in your code, it's because you've opened something that you haven't closed, and sometimes that problem doesn't show up till down below, and so you've got to really look when you're debugging your code. What is wrong with this? What did I forget? Yep, you've got to put your semicolon in there. So you are on blink, and then it'll print J. This is a print, so it won't advance. It will say you are on blink number, and then it will put in the next line J, and then because the second one's a print line, then on the second one it'll move down. But this will be a serial print. You'll do this, and then this will be on the same line, and then that serial print LN, that LN will take it to the next line. So let's take a look and see what this does. We will download it. And now let's click on the serial monitor. The red LED is blinking. You're on blink 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The red LED is blinking, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if you can watch this and the red LED at the same time, you can see that this is going very well. Now, there's a couple of things that I don't like. I think that it's hard to read this, you know, with the red. And so I think it would help if this UR line is indented. And also, I think I need a space between the colon and the 5, because I think that that's kind of confusing when you have number colon 1. It's not exactly clear what you're doing. And so let's clean this up a little bit. And on this print statement here, I'm going to put 3 spaces, and that'll indent all of those prints. And then also I'm going to put a space there so that I'm not jamming the number up against this colon. Okay, I put a little space in there, and I think that'll make it look neater. So let's try that. Okay, so you see this is indented, so I think it's easier to read. I like the white space that every time it loops through, it puts a white space in there. The red LED is blinking, and which blink you're on? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and then I think that is just pretty slick, and I think the printout that we're getting here is nice and readable. It's intuitive. It's not scrolling by too fast. I think that's looking really neat. Okay, there's another way that you can print a string, and that is a string can also be a variable. And so let's try that. Let's see if we can do that. Let's see, I go str. Okay. What I'm going to do is I'm going to talk about strings as variables in the next lesson, because this one is already getting a little bit too long. And so right now when we use strings, we'll just put them in quotes, and we'll talk about using characters and strings in a later video. But right now what I want you to do as an assignment is I want you to play with these print statements. I want you to reproduce what I've done. I also want you to make yours where you're doing the same thing down here in the yellow that that on your own, I want you to make it tell me that not just that I'm printing, that I'm blinking red like you see here, but I want you to also go in and put the yellow part. And then I want you to just play around and just sort of see things that you can do with the print statement. Okay, get comfortable with the print statement. Get comfortable with the serial monitor. Play around with different baud rates and just get to where you're doing this. But just in summary, always remember that if you're going to do this printing, you've got to start by turning your serial port on with a serial.begin, and when you do that, you have to make the baud rates match. 9600 is fine. Anything from 9600 to 115,200 will work. Okay, this is Paul McWhorter with toptechboy.com. We will talk to you later, and I hope to see you soon on the next lesson, which will be lesson number 5.